Hello friends, today we'll discuss the MCQs on forging, in which we'll cover the topics like drop forging, press forging, upset forging, open end close die forging, and the forging operations. And all these I'll discuss through the video as well as with respect to the some diagrams. So let's begin with the first MCQs. Which method is considered as one of the oldest method of giving the required shape to the metal? So expert considered forging as the oldest method of giving the required shape. For a long time, this forging was used by the smith with hammer. After that, this method was come into picture in the industries. And that's why we can say that the oldest method is the forging method, as compared if you see the casting or a forming, or even the last option is none of the mention. So it means that our answer is forging. Next question. In forging process, metals are shaped by, even if you see in this diagram, it is actually we are giving the impact on the heated metal. Okay, so in this case, in forging process, metals are shaped by the impact, and forging is a manufacturing process which shapes the metal with the help of a localized compressive force, and it shapes the metal with the impact force, and that's why our answer is A, impact. Next question. Smith forging can also be termed as, here also your answer is actually the open die forging, and basically we know that we are using the hammer which strikes and deform the workpiece, so which is placed on the stationary anvil. The die are usually flat in shape, and so in that case smithy forging can also be termed as a open die forging also. Next question. In which of the following forging operation repeated hammering and close die use? Hammering forging is also called as actually the drop forging, where a hammer hits the workpiece repeatedly to form its close die. Okay, and that's we can see in this diagram also, and that's why our answer is a drop forging. Means in a drop forging, we are giving the repeated blow over the component. Okay, and even in the you can see the close die here. Next question. In which of the following forging operation, instead of a repeated hammering, gradual force is applied? So press forging is a, or I can say in a press forging, gradual force is applied on the workpiece. The amount of time the die are in contact with the workpiece is measured in second. The main advantage of a press forging as compared to the drop hammer forging is its ability to deform the complete work. And that's why in this case, our answer is a press forging, because there will be a gradual force is applied over the component. Next question. Forging as a process is closely related to. It is closely related to actually the blacksmith, a person who makes and repair the things in the iron with an anvil and a hammer. And in that case, even nowadays, we can say as a smithy also. Okay, and that's why here the answer will be a D. Next question. In which forging process part are heated in open heart. Even if you see in the diagram, I have shown the this is the open heart, and we are going for the hand forging there right now. So basically, in a hand forging, parts are heated in a open heart because it is done in smithy job manually, and shaping is carried out with the hand tools. And here, your answer is very simple. It is a B, hand forging. Next question. Forging is carried out at which temperature? So forging is a process of forming. So it is of two type, that is a hot and a cold forging. So hot forging is done by heating a metal to about 60 to 65% of its melting temperature, thus above the recrystallization, right? And in the cold forging is generally used with a soft metal, usually done at the room temperature, thus below the recrystallization temperature. And that's why we can say that forging is carried out at a below or above the recrystallization temperature, which depends upon the whether it is a cold forging process or a cold or a hot cold forging process. Next question. Which of the following is an example of a impact pressure forging? Striking a blow is actually the example of an impact pressure, and shaping by a press is an example of a quiz press forging. And that's why we can say that the striking a blow is an example of impact pressure. We can I have shown in this diagram also, this person is giving a blow over the heated metal. Next question. Shaping of metal by quizzing them in between two or more die in order to obtain the desired shape is done by. So here in this case, forging is a term applied to a family of a process where the deformation is induced by a compressive force. The forging materials may be drawn out to increase the length and decrease the cross sectional. Okay. And many times, basically in the closed die forging, I can say that the impression die, we can produce the component in multidirectional flow. And that's why we are going for the, I can say two or more dies in that cases. And that's why our answer is a forging here. Next question. In impression die forging process, extra deformed material is produced, which is called as. So in a impression die forging process, flash can be produced, which is considered as a scrap material that is removed from the form part during the finishing of the metal parts. And here also you can see this is the how the flash is generated. Okay, so that will be an excess material which has to be removed, and that's why our answer is the A, flash. So extra deformed material which is produced is called as ultimately the flash. Next question. In which of the following techniques, shaping of a cross section of a tube or a rod is done by means of repeated impact or a blow? Basically, we know that swagging is a mechanical deformation techniques of reducing or shaping the cross section of a rod or a tube by means of a repeated impact or a blow. And here, that's why our answer is swagging. As shown, these are the, you can see these are the two dies, I can say, concave dies. And between that, we are just holding the circular cross section of the rod, and we are giving the impact over this die. Okay, so such operation is called as a swagging operation. Next question. Which of the following process is mainly used for making the connecting rod? So connecting rod are generally manufactured by the forging operations. In forging, the hammer is used which strikes on the heated metallic part to get the desired shape. And that's why here also your answer is D, forging. You can see here how we are making the connecting rod. Then the next question. In a drop forging, now in a drop forging, you can achieve the closed die impression also. Even the final shape is obtained in a number of steps. You can see from this diagram, you will not get directly. Okay, step by step you can get. And excess metal is provided purposely to ensure a complete filling of the die. Okay. So here all these conditions will be satisfied in the drop forging. And that's why our answer is all of the above. Next is metal flow in open die forging is. Now, if you see in this diagram, right now I have shown the one diagram here. In open die forging, the workpiece is compressed between the two flat dies, thus allowing the metal to flow without any restriction in the sideward direction related to the die surface. And that's why we can say that metal flow in the open die forging is practically unlimited. And that's why answer is B. Next question. Fillers are used for. So fillers is primarily the forging operation where a bar is elongated between the two fillers along its length to form a neck. And for that, we can see that I shown the in this diagram, top fillers and bottom fillers are there. Okay. And then we are giving the blow over the workpiece heated metal, which generates a necking type operations over that. Okay. And that's why fillers are used for necking down a piece of work. Okay. Our next question. Isothermal forging is also known as actually the answer is a hot forging process in which the metal part is maintained at the same high temperature. That means the forging die are also maintained at the same temperature. It's very simple. The temperature of the mold as well as the temperature of the work will be the same in the isothermal forging. And that's why basically I can say that such type of forging is very expensive than the conventional forging. And they are mainly used for material like the titanium or super alloy. And that's why our answer is here. The isothermal forging is also known as a hot forging process. Next question. Cast iron cannot be forged because it has a property of. So it is a property, you know very well, the cast iron having a property of brittleness. And brittleness is a, directly I can say that the brittleness is a property of cast iron, which breaks with a little or no deformation. Okay. So as its name suggests, cast, however, the cast iron is meant slowly to be cast. And so it cannot go for the, I can say for the forging process. Okay. Otherwise it will get break. And that's why our answer in this case, as according to the property of the cast iron is a brittleness. Next question. Heading is a kind of which forging operation? Heading is a kind of upset forging operation. Heading tools or a ram, you can see in this, this is the heading tool. And this heading tool is positioned perpendicular to the cross section end face of a rod or a bar, and it is gripped into the die. And on the application of the pressure, the length of the rod is reduced. and the diameter increases. Okay, so this process is essentially used to produce the bolt head or I can say the screw head. Okay, so heading is a kind of a upsetting operation. Our next question: press forging is a. Now, in this case, we can see here in this diagram, press forging is a slow squeezing action. You can see this is the ram. Okay, it moves very slowly, and so that's why our answer is B, slow squeezing action. Next question is: in open die forging, the hot metal is shaped between. So in open die forging is a hot forming process in which metal is shaped by the hammer or pressing between the two flat dies. You can see in this diagram. Okay, so that's why our answer is two flat dies. Next question: the flash refers to. Now, the excess metal that is squeezed out of the die cavity is referred as a flash. And that's why here our answer is flash refers to the excess metal flowing out of the die is ultimately the called as a flash. Next question, swagging. Here you can see again in the swagging, is a forging operation in which the two walls of this rotating die, that is open and close, and we are giving the impact, okay, impacting at the end of the heated tube. Okay, and that's why in this case your answer will be a C. Next question, bolts are produced by. I'll show you some process here. Generally, your answer is actually the bolts are produced by the upset forging. So here we are just feeding the workpiece between these gripping die, and then we can grip or we can hold that workpiece. And then what we are doing, we are giving the forward movement with the help of this punch. And then at the last, we'll get the required shape. But required shape is here we are producing a bolt right now. So that forging operation get completed, we can see, and the head will generate it. Okay. So the bolts are produced with the help of a upset forging. Okay. So thank you, friends.